Hey everybody, my name is BellPCC and welcome back to another episode of Banjo-Kazooie. I almost said Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time there. In the last episode we completed Gobi's Valley and we got the last jig of Freezeeasypeak along with both of their Gruntilda Lair ones. And in this episode we're going to go ahead and start on Mad Monster Mansion. But Mad Monster Mansion is in the complete opposite direction of where I'm going. But we need to go this way to actually open the level. So we're going to have to head towards the worst level of the game, because the picture for it is not too far from here. This level here, oh boy, in like 2 episodes time we'll be starting it, and it'll probably take me 3-4 episodes to do it. I absolutely hate it, so does everyone else who plays this game. I'll try to have co-commentators on for it, that'll be the fun bit of it. Anyway, the portrait for Mad Monster Mansion is just through here. It's not actually too hard to get to it, it's just a little bit annoying. So you come into this bit here, and then you see a fishy. So you're like, oh, look, a fishy. So you swim up, and this fish is going to try and kill you, most likely. Well, guess... Ow! Okay, is that your payback for me killing your friend in a couple of episodes ago, and Michael freaking out about it? Because that was funny. That really makes time for a good sample. And, of course, your filthy bread gives you a rash. Well, fucking wash yourself, then. I don't care about you saving cash. You're like someone I know. God. Mad Monster Mansion. Wait, I missed something. Hold on. I'll just cut to where I'm back up there. Okay. I forgot to get a mumble talking. It's going to be kind of useful, actually, because Mad Monster Mansion actually has Mumbo inside it, so has a Mumbo inside of it, and we do actually need to see this Mumbo because we need that Mumbo to actually help us unlock the next worlds. Yeah, so that's going to be fun. And as we swim along here, we're going to see a door thing. This is a door thing now, and I'm going to pretend this level doesn't exist just for my own sanity. Yes, my own sanity does matter. Because otherwise, how could I make these videos for you guys and still be entertaining? Well, for starters, I would have to be entertaining first. Oh well. Next place we want to go is, again, inside the Gruntilda's head thing over here, because that's where Mad Monster Mansion lives. It's just past the Gobi's Valley picture. I should be actually walking around with Kazooie out and not doing the rolling thing, because Kazooie's faster. Oh god, camera, excuse me. Oh god. So, you guys are probably wondering, why has there been no videos? And I'm like, I'm sorry guys, that's just not filled with recording Paper Mario. It feels like a chore to record it, actually. I did mention this in the update video, and it's just, ugh. So that's how I feel about the game right now. Anyway, Mad Monster Mansion. I'll just let you enjoy the music for a moment. Yeah, this place actually has some quite good music. Now, you may have seen me earlier hitting open a window and not going inside it. Well, I just didn't want to cancel the music mainly, but we do actually have to break all these windows and go inside anyway, because most of the time they will contain like notes or something, so I'm actually going to go into it now. Now, we can't do everything in this world yet. Now, you may be like, we have all the moves. Yes, we do. Doesn't mean anything. These two guests are rather dumb. Let's make sure they're unwelcome. That doesn't even rhyme! Rather dumb, unwelcome. What? I thought you were going to... Okay. Now, these normally have, like, these things inside it, so just be careful for that. And seriously, is that all that was in here? I remember there being more. Okay, screw. I forget I have this. I'm gonna use it. Yeah, I always forget I have the fucking invulnerability lines. So, and there was useless. Now, this main door here, we're not actually gonna go inside it through that method. Through that bit, because otherwise we can't actually get the jiggy that's in there. So let's go ahead and take the top entrance. Now, I'm going to say this place is probably going to take about an hour to complete. So, This is gonna be split up into two videos, and oh, come on, wait. I can't do this room yet, can we? Because we need the transformation, which we don't have yet. I want the feathers! You're not gonna need, well, you're gonna need rare feathers, but you're not gonna need that many of them in this world, so don't worry about fucking bats! Get away from me! This is the fucking Ocarina of Time or other fucking Zelda games. Fuck off! Fuck off! Oh my fucking god! Oh my god! Seriously! Thank you! Holy shit! Did that just actually happen? I'm gonna walk around this way and pretend it didn't happen. Okay, we're good. We good. Okay, we're good. And your claws clipping through the. Anyway, we're gonna want to break into here and inside. There are a bunch of notes, so we actually did have to come in here. So, we're... Now, you just gotta be careful, because these things are actually everywhere in this world, so... Yeah, just be careful of them. They are kind of annoying. And, because this level requires a lot of platforming... Yeah! Surprisingly, there's platforming in a platform game. So you want to be aware of that, because some of the platforming can be kind of annoying. Like... Come on, thank you. This is what I hate about the Xbox controller. It just sometimes flat out doesn't want to work for me. I'm gonna kill you. And that's actually the reference in this game to Project Dream. Project Dream was originally an RPG for the Super Nintendo that got moved to the N64. And the main villain of the game was the guy, that kind of pirate looking guy. Yep. He was Captain... I can't remember his name. But he actually also makes an appearance in the... sequel to this game, Banjo-Kazooie. And when I go get around to doing that, which I do plan to do someday, just not any time after Banjo for a while, because this project has been running way too long. I plan on doing that game, and I will point out stuff like that. Okay, pop up, please. God damn it. Oh, and we can't get that yet. So, this is one of the instances of a room that you have to open, but you can't actually do anything in it yet until you get the transformation, so... Ow, fuck off. I think that's everything up here we can do for now. But let me just check. See, a lot of things in here are going to require us to come back with the transformation. So, yeah, we're going to want to get that pretty shortly. No, I don't like this level. God. Anyway, there's a pipe there that we're going to have to interact with later, because again, we can't go down it just now, but hey, we might be able to later. And we are now Santa. Now, what you want to do here is you don't want to actually stand on anything wooden, like the wooden floor, basically. So, yeah, you want to do stuff like this. Now, if you're middle of your jumping animation, you hit the floor like I just did there, you're not going to actually activate. What you can do is just sneak inside this guy's body and steal his jiggy.
Goodness, God, how so... I can't...
Okay. So... Okay, Granty, you're gonna put your boot up somewhere, but... Why did she have a picture of Mumbo here? Mumbo? What are you doing behind my back with Gruntilda? Okay, go first person, please. Okay, so you got the broom, you got Mumbo, Clungo, Gruntilda, Dingpot, Gruntilda's sister, and Grunty's castle. How the fuck did they fit a castle in this room? Because that's obviously people... What the... Is that something else? I thought that was real, but it just turned out to be... Whatchamacallit? Yeah. Cobwebs. I forget names of things sometimes. But we do here. Anyway, you don't really need to do this. It's just something you can do to get an extra life, basically. So I'll become... Chandelier. And we get an extra life. And this basically is the main door that we went through earlier. Don't know how this house makes sense, but again, Nintendo logic. I can use that because this game was originally on the Nintendo system. And it was an exclusive until Rare was bought by Microsoft. Fuck you, Microsoft, by the way. For making one of the best video game companies. Am I in the right file? Yeah, I'm playing the right file. Oh, that's weird. But I have so much health. I thought I would have at least one left. I just noticed that too, so this burns the record. I'm like, am I playing the right file? But I am. Because I could have been logged into the wrong account and that would have screwed everything up. Anyway, down here you want to smash this. You want to smash it. Thank you. You want to smash that and come down here and inside. Yep. There's a bunch of things. Now that one there that has the crossover is important if you're doing stop and swap. Now, I'm going to... I got to play through the game again to do stop and swap because unfortunately... this way. Because this account does not have Banjo Nuts and Bolts enabled on it, so... yeah. I have to actually go ahead and use the account on this Xbox. It does! Wish I could fuck off. Again! I forget I actually have this. So, there we go. But I do have another account prepared for this, it's just I need to go ahead and actually play up to this point again, because I've already gotten all the stop and swap eggs on it. So, I'll need to do that, but that's why stop and swap's going to be a little bit after the main game. But don't worry, I will cover stop and swap. When I can. I don't know when that's going to be, but it will be someday. Anyway, let's leave the basement. Cellar. Wine cellar. That's what it is. It's a wine cellar! Let's see. Oh, look, notes. Now, what you want to be doing around here as well is just now you want to actually destroy all these gates when you can. We could go to Mumble right now, but yeah. Anyway, let's put some eggs into these guys because I think they might want some. Said might want poop. Poop!
Thank you.
Did you just say fuck you? Well, fuck you too! Yeah, the way they make say thank you sounds a lot like fuck you, which is kind of funny for a challenge game. So, yeah, I'm gonna emphasize what they say.
Thank you.
Well, fuck you too. See, told you I wasn't child friendly. Okay, get the honeycomb piece. Honeycomb piece, a bit of honeycomb. Now, we're doing this to actually get a Jiggy, so don't think this is like me just showing off them just saying fuck you. This is important. Like, seriously, when do I not ever do things that are important? Okay, you made your point. Watch me not edit that together to put something there and just... yeah. Makes me look like a dumbass. Actually, I'm not gonna too, because I've got time pressure to actually edit this episode in. I've only got a day. Actually, not even got a day, I've got like an hour to do it in. Yeah. Anyway, I got a jiggy. So yeah, do a little jig. Now, Banjo-Kazooie. What? You can go in here? I don't think in here has anything important, because I don't even remember ever being in here. No it doesn't, it just has items. I've never been in here before. Ever. Not even during my last recording of this. Which, kind of, I ended up rushing it, so that's why I'm re-recording the entire game, basically. So, let's collect the notes, thank you. I mean, fuck you. Now, we're also gonna have to go into this church here. Yep, a church. Quite literally. And there's another token up here. Now, going in here takes you up to the top here, which is where we actually want to be. I'm just going to go ahead and put the notes because I don't want to come back up here. Now be careful, if you fall from this height, obviously you are going to die. Because that would make the most sense. And how high can we go? And we got Jiggy for coming all the way up to the top. So just take a little look at the level right now. Yeah. This is a level. So just jump down here and we'll be fine. Now I'm actually gonna go ahead and get that Jinjo just now because I don't wanna like start setting things up and then die because this game's N64 roots, it still has some of the issues that the N64 one does. Even though it saves notes and jiggies between deaths, it does not save the level status, however you say it. Actually people say it different ways, so level status is the way I say it. And it doesn't save the level status, so Like, any gate you break down or window you open will reset if you die or leave the level. So just gotta remember that. Because that would obviously be the worst thing that could possibly happen to you. Anyway, Jinjo. I've only got one more to get, wow. I'm doing this in a completely different order from last time, like the Jinjo was the last thing I got. Anyway, Mumble Token over there. We're gonna need a lot of Mumble Tokens in the next few worlds, because we have this world, then we have the last world, which the last world I think costs 25? And I think this one costs 20, so we've got a good few tokens we're gonna have to collect. But don't worry, they're quite plentiful now. They're not rare at all. Like, there's one there. Oh, see what I did there. Rare. I didn't even mean to do that pun. I'm sorry, guys. I'll go kill myself now. Can I collect that? No. I already have full health. Anyway, I do hate the maze because of those ghosts, but hey. Shit. Oh, come on. So, yeah. I'm hoping to get this game done fast now because I actually want to record it, surprisingly. I actually want to record something. And of course we've got the enemies here. Now, in this world, I think basically every enemy is, you know, unkillable via normal means. Some flammability feathers are always nice! Is that this bit? Cut me. I did that again. Am I missing something? Oh, maybe just go jump them up here. I forget things sometimes. Nope, that didn't even work. Hmm. Oh, well duh! There's a fucking pad here. Didn't say I was good at this game. Oh yeah, that was my last Jinjo. And we got ourselves a Jiggy. Appears to be something underneath this thing. There we go. So we got another Econ Bogum. I mean, Mumble Token. And you... Damn, I want to destroy that too. So I'm going to have to go to the other side. And that's the thing about this game. Until really I explore a whole level, I can't really start cutting things out because... Well... Then you would not know where I was going. That's how I feel. Like... The next episode of this world is going to be able to be cut down to shit because... Yeah, I've explored most of it in this episode. Now you may be like, oh, this board's gonna split into two parts. Well, kind of has to. It's gonna be way too big otherwise. I'll come back and do that later. I'd want to go ahead and open that gate just now, actually. Because it'd be nice to have all the gates open quite soon. Which is what we're gonna have to do. So break the gate. That's that gate open. Can we do what's over here yet? I think we can. Let me just check. I think we can, but I think it's difficult. So I know there's a lot of tentacles here. Yeah, we can technically do it just now. Okay, so, we're not supposed to come and get this for a while. Come on. But we can. But I'll come back and get the notes later because that'll be easier. Because I won't have to worry about my water level, basically. But I'll collect all the things while we're here, because that's what we do. I thought I'd seen something at the back of the well. Wouldn't surprise me, that's what Rare likes to do in this game. Get back here. And we get some Madeline boots over here, but we don't need those. We can platform. At least, I think we can platform. I'm not going to say you can platform or not. I don't know if you can or... speaking of platforming, it turns out I can't platform. Never mind. I'll just pretend I can. What? Game? What? That's why I hate this game doesn't really have a grab mechanic. It's kind of annoying. My hair's getting in my eyes now. That's great. And you got a haircut. So we're going to go ahead now back to that shed, so I'll see you guys there. Okay, back at the shed, we're going to want to break open this door and go inside. And this thing, the last time I played it, kind of confused me a little bit. Like, how do I get this Jiggy? But then I figured out I could just stand on top of it. And... I got to do something I'm bad at. That's a Z. I've got to do something bad up. I've got a spell! Yay! Is that an N? Maybe a N J. Where's a J? You know, this is really nice. Okay, so I need to now get Banjo K. Where's the K? K. K. I think it's A's in its letter? Yay! Hey! Is this A? B A. K A Z. Z Z Z Z. Z. Oh, I need the O. Where's the other O? Oh. 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 I think that's it. Welcome to having dyslexia. Fucking welcome to video games that give you a time limit to spell something. Ugh. It's always bugged me. Okay, I'll leave the gun in the chest so I can get there. And I'll say this right now. In this game and in Banjo-Tooie, I hated these jiggies for some reason of... Let's just say this. I had to grab the box of the game to be able to spell it. Yeah. Luckily, now that I'm older, I've actually memorized how to spell it. So, yeah. That's annoying, isn't it? Oh well, fucking, let's forget about that and just move on. Actually, and I'll say this right now, I wasn't even sure I was spelling Kazooie right when I was doing that there. Anyway, the only thing we really have to do now is the church. But I think I'll leave that for the next episode. So next time on Banjo-Kazooie, we will go ahead and go into the shed. I'll see you guys then. This is BillPZC, signing out. Goodbye, guys.